between Feast of Trumpets and Day of Atonement are what is called the 10 Days of Awe. And these 10 days between the Feast of Trumpets, which is supposed to awaken ourselves and awaken our spirits to the reality that we need to change, that we need to repent, that we need to focus on taking a personal inventory and introspection and evaluate our lives and to see what we need to repent of and to see what we need to begin putting into our lives and adding to our lives to make it better. Sins of omission, things that we should be doing but we're not. During these 10 days of awe, we traditionally look at the 10 commandments and take the first 5 commandments and relate them to our personal relationship with God, because the first set of 5 deals with commandments regarding to God. So we get ourselves right with God and get our personal relationship with God in order. And then the last 5 commandments, the last set of 5, is dealing with man's relationship with man. And during these last 5 days before Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur, we reach out to our fellow man, reconcile differences, mend fences, ask for forgiveness for any wrongs that we've done other people. And so in that vein, I would like to just take the first commandment. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. A lot of times when we read this verse, we think of, you know, pagan deities of the Canaanite nations, Baal and Ishtar and Ashtoreth and Molech and Dagon and Chemosh, etc., etc. But a god is anything that we put before God himself. This could be our spouse. This could be our children. This could be a political leader. This could be a religious leader. This could be not only a person, but it could be a thing. It could be our jobs. Are we slaves to our jobs? Do we serve our jobs and put our job before everything else? We even leave family on the sidelines and on the back burner in order to make more money, in order to please the boss, in order to climb the corporate ladder. Do we put our education before everything else? Do we put our own pleasure and our own entertainment above everything else? An idol could be a TV show that we skip church or synagogue for, or that that we get immersed in, and maybe it's something ungodly that we really shouldn't be watching or entertaining ourselves with. It could be a music group. It could be a hobby. It could be an addiction. It could be drugs or alcohol or sex. Anything that we put before God, before his word, before the Messiah, anything that we do to grieve the Holy Spirit and to ignore his leading and guidance and direction into all truth, that is considered an idol. That is considered a god. And it says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. So let's take some time today to see if we've put any other gods before us. If we are making anybody or anything else a priority over our personal relationship with God. God is our creator. He is our life giver. He is our God. He is our king. But also he is our father. And he loves us and he wants to bless us and give us good gifts. But if we don't put him first and we don't obey his word and walk in the footsteps of Yeshua, Jesus, our Messiah, by walking and following in the commandments, we've made him second place. And in the pagan pantheon, there was a head god and he was worshipped, but all the other lower gods underneath this head god of the pantheon was worshipped too. And God says, no, none of that. You know, I'm not to be worshipped second or third. I'm not to be worshipped and then all this other stuff is worshipped underneath me. I alone am to be exalted, acknowledged, and worshipped. There is only one God. This is a monotheistic faith, folks. So in these 10 days of awe, let's spend today focusing on if we have put anything or anyone ahead of God in our lives. Shalom and God bless during these 10 days of awe.